the successful deployment of ESA's latest mission to the Sun, Solar Orbiter, launched on the 10th of February 2020. There won't be scenes like this again in Mission Control for a long time. Today, as this phone footage shows, the corridors of the European Space Operations Centre, ESOC, are empty. Each mission control room has just one or two people. The majority of the operations, planning and monitoring work for 21 spacecraft is taking place in nearby homes.
It's a strange feeling to be preparing commands in my little office here at home. I never thought I would ever do that.
Launched in 2018, BepI Colombo is on its way to Mercury. But in April, it flew past Earth, a critical manoeuvre to adjust its speed and trajectory, and a major event for the mission team. But most remained at home, with only a small socially distanced group in mission control to monitor the spacecraft.
We had to get used to work differently, to coordinate differently among the team members. This had some overhead for sure. But overall, I have to say, we've been also supported by a very stable spacecraft. The trajectory was so stable that we didn't have to do trajectory correction maneuvers beyond the one we did on the 26th of February. After that, we didn't have to do any more. And the platform itself was also very well behaved. And this helps a lot in these conditions, of course.
Not everyone's been so fortunate. Since 2002, ESA's integral mission has been successfully observing violent cosmic explosions such as gamma-ray bursts. Then, on the 13th of April, power systems on the spacecraft suddenly reset, probably due to the effect of a cosmic ray. Integral started to rotate, exposing delicate instruments to the heat of the sun. With the spacecraft switched to safe mode, the team used an emergency procedure developed almost 20 years ago to restore operations.
We had just the one engineer on site, and then another engineer connected from home to the mission control system and shared his desktop with the entire team. So we were sitting at home with a shared control system desktop, one guy on site, and my old procedure. And it worked, but it was a totally different work experience. Very interesting day.
Another ESOC team has been working hard, at home, to avoid the unexpected. With Earth surrounded by a cloud of space debris, these analysts plot satellite positions and plan manoeuvres to prevent collision. Several satellites have had to be manoeuvred to avoid risky debris objects. Even new capabilities are being added. Testing of ESA's laser space communication system is underway between the new EDRS-C and Sentinel satellites, and data from ESA's science and Earth observation missions continues to flow, revealing new discoveries and providing vital information on, for example, weather, climate and pollution.
They are essential data for our economy, for our people, for the environment, for our planet. So we have continuously deliver this data. There has been only a very, very tiny reduction in the use of this data because we deliver nominally and all the data provided to the community as in other times, as in normal times outside the crisis.
Thanks to preparations made over the last few years to plan for an emergency, ESOC has been able to quickly adapt to home working, maintaining the missions and services Europe relies on.
Thank you.